comparisons with 50 Shades of Grey will be made, have been made?
I haven't seen 50 Shades of Grey, but I realize many people, I should maybe watch it, because all the journalists speak to me about this
film. You didn't expect it?
I didn't expect it, what?
That the comparisons would be made.
I haven't seen the film, so I don't know.
You might have heard about it, yes.
I've heard about it. I think maybe my film is more twisty, no?
It's definitely better. So.
Okay, thank you.
T'aurais aimé avoir un frère?
Un frère?
Moi, j'ai toujours souffert d'être fini.
Ça m'a jamais manqué. J'ai une enfance très heureuse.
Et un frère jumeau?
Merci. On voit l'impression permanente d'avoir un miroir en face de soi.
Peut-être que t'en as un sans le savoir.
Those poor twins. There's always something wrong with them in films. Why did they interest you?
J'ai toujours été fasciné par les jumeaux. J'ai souvent traité le thème du double dans mes films. Là, je me suis confronté de manière beaucoup plus frontale à travers les jumeaux, parce que quand j'ai découvert le livre de Joyce Carol Oates, j'ai tout de suite senti qu'il y avait la possibilité de faire un thriller érotique très excitant avec beaucoup d'enjeux de mise en scène. Et donc voilà, ça m'excitait de parler de la gémellité.
But why? I mean, why are you interested, do you think? And why is film so interesting?
You're not fascinated by twins? No?
That's a very good question. I think so what is it?
For me, twins are the masterpiece of nature. That's why she's working in a museum. And that's why there is the scene with the young twins, you know, the children. For me, it's amazing to imagine that nature is able to create two persons with the same face, same body, but different inside. So it's there is a mythology around the twins, which has always excited me and fascinated. And I have no twin.
No.
I have a brother and two sisters. And I don't know if I would have liked to have a twin. I don't know. It's a good question. But maybe after watching this film, people will be afraid of twins.
A little bit about Marine. In fact, was she difficult to get into this role? Or?
It's the second time I work with Marine. We met Young and Beautiful some years ago, and she was very young when she made the film, and we became friends after Jeune et Jolie. And I wanted to work again with her and to give her the opportunity to show something else of her talent, because she's very skilled, do you say that? And she's beautiful, the camera loves her, and at the same time she's very strong. And she was afraid of nothing. And the good thing was the chemistry between her and Jeremy. And it was very important because there are some very difficult scenes.
Je m'appelle Eva, j'ai 25 ans. Et je vis avec un homme que j'adore. Il m'aime, mais je ressens parfois une vraie solitude avec lui. Comme un manque.
Et vous faites l'amour avec votre ami?
Oui. Bien sûr. Je pense que tout vient de la mort de ma mère. Même morte, je sens qu'elle me surveille, qu'elle me juge. Mais je vous dis tout ça sans être sûre que vous puissiez m'aider.
Si vous suivez mon mode de thérapie, qui vous reviendra cher, Je pense pouvoir vous guérir, si vous arrêtez de me mentir.
Vous mentir?
Votre sœur, je n'y crois pas. Vous êtes fille unique, je me trompe. Et votre mère est-elle vraiment morte, ou bien souhaitez-vous sa mort? Mentir pour séduire, c'est une pratique courante chez les jolies femmes. Surtout quand elles sont frigides.
It was first Marine, and after I met many French actors to see what was the best couple. You know, I wanted to test them together before taking
somehow,
my decision.
Somehow, Jeremy, I didn't expect him in this role, and I wasn't sure when I saw it on paper if he was perfect, but he was very good in this role.
He's great, and pour moi, Jeremy est un peu comme un acteur américain. Il aime beaucoup composer, il a un côté acteur studio, et en travaillant avec lui sur ce film, j'ai beaucoup pensé à un autre acteur avec qui j'ai travaillé, c'était Michael Fassbender, qui est un acteur aussi qui s'investit vraiment dans le rôle physiquement.
And how did you let him dive physically in this role? What did you have him do?
You have to ask him the question, but
you didn't ask him anything.
I asked him to be sexy.
Be sexy for me, Jérôme.
Please be sexy because you'll be very often naked. And women and men must be excited by you on screen. So he did a little sport to be sexy. But he's sexy in life, so it was not very complex.
And the beard helps.
And the beard helps because I wanted him to be viril.
Viril.
And a real man.
Somewhere by I think an American journalist, and he said that this is psychosexual euro sleaze.
Is it good? It's a good thing.
I think so, but I don't think he meant it as a compliment.
It was not a compliment for him.
I think he meant this as something like the perverted European. I'm not sure. Is it very European, do you think? Because it was an American story.
I made it very French, maybe. But it's a loose adaptation. But I think with genre you have to push all the limits, and with this kind of movie you don't have to be tedious. You have to go very deeply in the story and not to be afraid of effects. And so it was important for me to push the limits and to play with the audience.
And it was very French. Or what would you say is very French?
I don't know if it's very French. I'm very French, so I think I don't know. It's up to you to tell me if you think this kind of character are particularly French. I think in France we are not afraid of sexuality like in some other countries. We are less. You know, the film is forbidden under 12 in France. I don't know what will happen in the other countries. I don't know
it'll
yet.
It'll probably be 16.
Maybe 16, we don't know.
So
we'll see.
So this whole group of French boys and girls from 12 to 16, they will be traumatized by the strap-on.
I think the young people are not traumatized by this kind of movies. They are used to watch many dreadful things on internet, and it's very easy to find this kind of images. So I think there is a kind of hypocrisy, but it's the world of today.